thank you for this stream of consciousness. No, really, from the heart. Practical application of OBE. Question. Lucid dreaming, I have some experience with it, although many years ago. It's extremely vivid and real. As I understand now, OBE is even more so, yet continuous in the sequence of what's happening.
Yes.
And free will still. How do I get there? I mean, how does one get there? Because we're worlds apart, me and people that can do this, because the only limitations is the beliefs.
Beliefs and fears.
And fears.
Yeah.
And it seems that, you know, it's my intellect is my chains. And the intellect not being smart, but the whatever it comes with it. What are the practical steps from step by step for a beginner? How do I get out of the body? Like, what do I do?
Okay.
Sorry for this question. It sounds like stupid.
No, the steps are mostly just what we've been doing. What we've been doing are the steps that will lead you to getting out of the body on demand whenever you want to, quickly and easily, as opposed to learning how to climb up a rope, which will be sporadic and every once in a while, because you're not really, you're not working at it in a straightforward way. And it depends on your attitude and your intellect at any particular time, so it's very changeable from time to time. So the way you get there, to make it easy and whenever you want to, is exactly what we've been doing. There's a few basic steps you have to learn first. One is to let go of the physical reality, a good meditation state, so that you're not processing the physical. That's the first thing. That makes it easier. Now, you know, you can process both. But if you start out trying to process both, you'll probably just not do as well. That's not the easy way to get there. So we start with letting it go. Okay. The second thing is get out of your head. Work from the being level. Be able to stay in that being level whenever you want, as long as you want. Make that a stable state that you're aware of that you can access. Not jump in and out of it, you know, every time something flies by or something happens, you jump into your intellect, but a stable state where you can get into the being level and stay there as long as you like. Okay. The next thing that you need to do is you need to get rid of your fear. You need to work on those fears. The way you work on your fear is you start by finding them. Fear is hard to find. We have all sorts of fears. If we feel inadequate, we don't know that we feel inadequate. All we know is that we've got these feelings that when somebody triggers us by criticizing us or telling us that we're not good enough at something or doing like that, it hits our button and we get angry and we maybe, you know, lash back or we go sulk or, you know, go cry somewhere. We, you know, we have this big reaction to it because really what the problem is not that rude individual. The problem is the fear that you have. So you get rid of the fears. You do that by looking at the ego. Fear is hard to find because you deny it. You push it down under the rug where you can't see it. That's what the ego does. But that leaves the ego out right where you're going to look at it. So how do you know that's ego? If you have a feeling, if you have a response, a reaction that isn't full of love and joy and peace and caring and smiles, then that's your ego. Anytime you get angry, you get upset, you get annoyed, you get irritated, you're anxious, you're stressed, all of that is your fear. If you didn't have the fear, you wouldn't be any of those negative things. Your life would be nothing but joy and peace and contentment. So it's the fear that gives us the negative things. So here you are, and you have something happens to you, and you get angry. Oh, that's one of those negative things. Trace it back to the fear. Why am I angry? And the first thing you have a tendency to do is say, well, I'm angry because he said so-and-so and so-and-so. It's his fault that I'm angry. Well, you have to own it and be responsible for who you are. So it's not anybody's fault. You choose to be angry. You have other choices. You don't have to be angry. You choose that. You choose it mostly because of fear. So the ego's easy to spot. It's negative. Creates negative experiences, negative feelings. Every negative feeling is attached to a fear. You wouldn't have it if you didn't have the fear. Find the real reason you get angry. You get angry because you're insecure, because you feel inadequate, and that person made that feeling of inadequacy kind of swell up, and you really dislike that and want to get rid of it. So the anger was like a cover for it. Instead of dealing with it, you get angry and blame it on somebody else. Okay, so that's the other thing. Work on those fears. It may take you a decade to get rid of your fears, but work on them. Work on them until you live in a happy, peaceful place. So now we have all the ingredients that we need to go out of body. Okay, you can let go. You can stay in the being level at a stable, you know, stable place. You know the difference. You have your intellect under control. Stay in the being level, and you've gotten rid of, not necessarily every fear, but you're getting offloaded a lot of your fear, because you'll work on that fear a long time. So in 6 months or a year, you might offload enough of it. You probably spend all your life offloading all of it. So you then, at that point, when you understand that this is a virtual reality with data streams, you have no trouble from a being level having an intent from the being level that you can just connect to the larger consciousness system. And going out of body takes you less than a second, just with an intent. There's no transition. There's nothing going on other than your intent says, I want to go back there. There you are. Because you need to be able to drop the reality, being level, intent, and it's done. It's just that easy. Then is when you usually start to learn how to parallel process. Well, that's nice, but I got to leave here to go there. And when I'm there, I'm not here. And when I'm here, I'm not there. That's not too convenient. So let's be here and there all together. So then you start working, and your reality, instead of being two bifurcated things, becomes one whole thing. And then you live here and there all at once. And then you live in this bigger reality. And then it's even easier yet. It's not a matter of attaching to another data stream. You're connected to 3 or 4 data streams all the time. So that's kind of the steps. And basically, we've started that. Remember, on the first day, I said, I'm not trying to teach you to be wizards and wizardesses. Wizardinis? Witches. That doesn't sound good. That doesn't sound good at all. They have long, bony noses with warts on them. Okay. So anyway, so that's not the point. The point is to give you the fundamentals that you can work with on your own to develop this the rest of your life, you know, over the next decade or two. And that's what we're doing here, is just these basic steps and ideas, and you got just enough of a carrot that you got some healing right, and you got some diagnosing right, and you got a few remote views, just enough to say, hey, this stuff works. There's really something to it. And then you'll work on, and you'll find out that eventually you give up on all that stuff because it isn't important anyway. But the process of developing it really develops you and your empathy and your connection to other people. So that's kind of the path. That's where we're going, and that's what we're doing here. But, you know, like all other things like this, it's easy to say and harder to do. So it takes time. But this has to be something that's not, you know, a week retreat. This has to be something that's part of your lifestyle, part of your life, that you're going to grow up. You're going to learn. You're going to get rid of your fear, all that stuff. You know, you're going to get control of your awareness such that you can stay in a being level steadily, consistently. You don't hop out, jump around. So that's where you're going. That's the path to get there. And now you just have to take, you know, the next 2 or 3 decades and work on it. So it seems like a long time, but hey, it's just the rest of your life. What else you have to do? You know? You can do this in any environment. You do not have to shave your head and put on a yellow robe and go, you know, sit in a lotus position, you know, in a monastery someplace. That's not necessary. Matter of fact, it's, I think, better to stay right where you are and work on it in this environment. Because when you become part of that monastery, all right, it's easier in the short run. You don't have all the distractions. But it's harder in the long run because you don't have all of the challenges either. Here you've got challenges. Every day you run into people that are going to challenge your ego. Everywhere. And the most significant and obvious person that's going to challenge your ego is your significant other. That's what they're there for, right? They're going to do things. It's going to pull that ego out of you because that's where you connect with somebody at the deepest level. And that'll just, pluck your magic twanger and you'll just, won't know what to do and your anxiety and upset and all that stuff will just come out in that relationship because that's the deep connection. That's where you're most vulnerable, that deep connection. That's where most of your wants and needs and things are. You see, all of that fear stuff is there. That ego plays in that. So you get involved in that. You shave your head, put on an orange robe, and go sit in a monastery. All that's gone, supposedly. All that's gone. Well, that doesn't help. You need that challenge in order to grow up. That's the thing that you do. And where the rubber meets the road in growth is relationship. That's the key thing. In a monastery, relationship's kind of constrained. So, the optimal spiritual path isn't to become an ascetic and live in a cave and meditate 20 hours a day. That'll get you a little bit there, but it won't challenge you to the point that you really grow up. You'll have great theory and great practice in a really small space, but that's not where it's optimum, right where you are. Going to work, dealing with your boss, dealing with your coworkers, and trying to live amicably and lovingly with your significant other. That's where that's the challenge for most of us. So you don't have to change anything. Don't have to change your life. Don't have to change your job. Don't have to sell your house and go join a commune. You don't need to do any of those things. Just live your life aware in the moment. Make good choices. Quiet your mind, and all the rest will take care of itself. So that's how you get out of body. Yeah. Easy, huh? Yeah, really, really easy.